What's going on, everyone? I'm Mackenzie Mitchell. This is my friend and co-host, Alicia Taylor.
What's up?
What's up? What's next? How you doing?
Mackenzie Mitchell, I'm great. I have a gift for you that I'd love to start the show off with.
Please stop. Please.
Just
stop.
One second.
Here we go. I don't ever like your gifts. The last time this happened, you put a popper in my face. Swear to God, if that popper comes back, I will pop you, girl. Stop, you're scaring me. What are you doing? I thought it was gonna be like a ferret or something.
Someone gave these to me, and I wanted to share them with you. Fresh eggs, farm fresh eggs. Farm fresh.
Why are you giving me eggs?
Someone gave them to me, and I know that you love them.
Are you gonna egg me or something? Because if
no.
So, I gotta take off this jacket.
Absolutely not. That's why I said they're not hard boiled. Don't drop them.
Thank you for the
eggs. It's very dangerous. You're welcome.
I also think that we should go back to what we were gonna start.
Yeah,
this
let's do it. Let's do it before we.
Congratulations to our friend Bronson Reed, the new NXT North American Champion.
Yes.
Woo! 14 years in the making. How special of a moment,
Mackenzie Mitchell. It is officially Thick Boy season.
Yes, it is.
And I'm glad to be a part of Thick
Boy. I'm not mad about it.
I was almost going to cry on Tuesday night. And I'm not, you guys know I'm not very emotional.
Okay.
But seeing Bronson Reed just watching the whole match, I was so involved. And he's a friend of us here.
I know.
What's next? And just his wife was there. I was overcome.
That's what he said. When I asked him, I said, did you plan to get emotional? You know, when you got the victory, and he said, no, I didn't. I'm not an emotional person. But all of a sudden, everything just came together. And it was my wife was there. It was the fire. It was just the pyro. It was just everything together.
I had to get away from the pyro because I didn't want, you know, all that to happen. But Bronson Reed, he is kind of more of an emotional guy because he has cats. I always love men that have cats.
Okay, well.
They're always my friend. Always my friend. Josiah, you have cats?
I'm a dog person myself. But speaking of dogs, Presley, Frankie Monet,
yes,
making her debut next week. We actually, on Tuesday night, were on our way to find Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, and say thank you, which we eventually got there. But we had this little run-in with Frankie Monet.
So Ted DiBiase's here.
He's
We've got to say thank you somehow. Did you get a card?
I didn't get a card because I thought the money.
Hello. Just Frankie Monet here to remind you that the greatest week of your life starts next week when I debut first on NXT TV on Tuesday and then on What's Next on Thursday. And if you're wondering where Presley is, I mean, he's in hair and makeup, of course, getting a blow up. See you next week.
Normally, I would be mad that someone interrupted us, but
yeah,
it is Frankie Monet.
It is Frankie Monet. Okay, now about Ted DiBiase. So how are we going to get that? How are we going to say thank you? We have to figure this out.
I got an idea. Okay. Let's go.
Okay, so watching it back now, does it make you mad that she came in and interrupted what we were trying
to
do?
I'm still not mad about it because she ultimately was promoting that she's going to be here on the show.
That's true.
Next week. I was thinking, should we get like some treats or something for Prince Presley?
Well, I know he likes turkey bacon, so maybe I'll just cook up these eggs.
Oh.
And bring some turkey bacon.
I was gonna say that's not turkey bacon, but you think he'll
those?
Well,
I know, but he would probably like eggs too because everybody likes breakfast foods. Also next week, Bobby Fish versus Pete Dunne. I was there with Bobby Fish when it all started and culminated with the whole situation with Pete Dunne. He was like, I've got a vendetta, a debt that needs to be paid, and that's gonna be with Pete Dunne after what happened at War Games.
Bobby Fish has been gone this entire time. The Undisputed Era imploded before all of our eyes. You cried, speaking of emotions,
with the
Undisputed Era. And now Bobby Fish is back. What is going to happen?
I don't know. It's not going to be pretty. I can say that. He's got vengeance against Pete Dunne, naturally.
Yes.
And we'll see what happens when they get in the ring next week. Also next week, Cameron Grimes. I don't know if we can call him friend of show since he was here last week. I think he had good intent coming by.
He did have good intent. He put up quite the fit here.
Ted DiBiase!
Right here.
Sure did.
Right here.
It's really a sight to see, but Cameron Grimes will have a face-off with our new friend, Ted DiBiase, the Million Dollar Man. We actually got to say thank you for being our silent investor.
Oh my God, I was so excited to talk to the
I was nervous.
Million Dollar Man. You were nervous.
Yeah.
But we did take that big... Let's show him.
Yeah.
Let's show him.
You go first.
Me
first.
You go first.
Excuse me.
Hello, Mr. DiBiase.
Hi.
Alicia Taylor, Mackenzie
Mitchell.
Thank you so much for all that you've done for What's Next. We really appreciate you.
We are so excited about the new set.
We were going to get you a card, but we figured we'd get you something else that you liked more.
We would much rather have a big bucket of money.
Here you go, sir.
You guys have figured it out. And what you figured out?
What did we figure out?
That everybody's got a price for the $1 million man, including the $1 million man. That's pretty good. That's not bad, but a little deeper.
A little deeper.
I can't thank you enough.
Hey, this one shouldn't be in there.
You want some more?
I'm actually very surprised with your laugh, but I have to ask you, what did you do with the money that you stole from him? That was a
gift, Alicia.
Excuse me.
I didn't steal any money from the $1 million.
Can we replay that again? Maybe in slow-mo.
Let's not.
On the topic of stealing, next week, something that might steal the show. Something might steal the show. Finn Balor, Karrion Kross.
Yes.
For the NXT Championship.
What a battle that is going to be, Mackenzie Mitch. Will Finn Balor get redemption?
That's the big question.
Kross?
That's the big question. And will Scarlett be ringside? I'm sure she will. That will add an extra layer of intensity to it. You'll be there, front row seat. I'll be there, backstage, probably staying very clear of this match because things can get a little off the walls when it's Finn Balor and Karrion Kross. We know that.
What's Scarlett going to be wearing? She gonna get involved in that match and help Karrion Kross out?
You know, she could. She could wear that like jacket that she's got with points on it. The spikes, exactly.
Most of her outfits are dangerous.
Yeah. Okay. So
it's gonna be dangerous.
Should we place bets on what Scarlett's wearing next week?
I don't want to place bets because you said that I stole the money. I don't have any.
You did steal the money.
I don't have any money to bet.
Okay. Well, it's been awesome here this Thursday morning. It's been such a pleasure being here with
you. You have to go cook the.
No, I'm saving these for Prince Presley. He loves eggs.
All right, guys, do not miss NXT action every Tuesday live on the USA Network. And, of course, spend your Thursdays with the hit WWE series.
Smash series. Smash series.
Smash hit. What's next? Mackenzie Mitch. Here.